Ingo Rademacher, and I'm here with this brand new amazing Toyota Sienna 2021. It only comes in a hybrid and it comes with all-wheel drive. Today we are testing the Platinum Edition and it is marvelous. There's so much room for the children. I'm gonna start talking like a car guy now. Ta-da!
Who's gonna drive that? It's a minivan.
Yeah, I know, but what if you put like a 3-inch lift kit on it and then black out the wheels, put some black chrome on it, and she's walking away. Hey, honey, it's just a loaner, and I really wanted to try it because I love minivans. I know that you don't, and a lot of the fans on the comments said that we should get an SUV. I think it was about 80%, 20%, I think.
They know.
Yeah. But I really wanted to try this new Sienna because it has such a great interior layout for the family. So let's go.
The reason we wanted to do this was because my wife's bougie Range Rover is too small and we have an additional little bubba coming. So we're gonna have three kids and a dog and a bunch of gear to take to Mammoth. And one of the key things that it must have is a reclining third row, a comfortable one, and it has to have some kind of autonomous driving feature. And the Sienna has that. So this is how we would probably sit on our way to Mammoth once the baby's born. Prismo is playing the part of the baby as well as himself today. Peanut would probably sit right there. You got a pretty decent amount of legroom right now, right? Show us how much legroom you actually can have. And you can interact with the third row where Haku would sit. He would have those two seats. We would fold that one down. You guys could even play cards together, couldn't you?
Mm-hmm.
On Prismo, you would be cruising right there. Jump down. Boy, sit. Sit, sit, sit. What? How'd you guys do that so fast? There's room for Prismo, who's playing two parts today. Good boy. And look at the amount of leg room Peanut has. Stretch out. Look at that. And Peanut's 5'8". And lean that seat all the way back. Recline it even more. Look at that. It's just nothing can come close to this in an SUV, which is why we're trying the minivan. And recline that third row for me. And there's still plenty of trunk space.
That much trunk space still.
Plenty.
Plenty of trunk space.
And you can still sleep, go to a beach.
You can sleep back there, right?
Yeah, of course I could sleep back there and here.
And Peanut, you got armrests on both sides too, yeah?
Yeah.
Also, what do we got here? Heated seats. Unfortunately, that only comes on the Platinum. So you gotta spend the extra money just to get the heated seat. That's definitely a bummer. This is how loaded we are.
Fully loaded.
Fully loaded. Got so much stuff to take. Got these vintage skis that we're gonna hang on the wall.
Yeah, it's mine.
And we got our wood in the back for hardwood floors. Bunch of extra toilet paper because it's 2021. We're getting there. Pohaku and I are in here just playing around. What do you think that's for?
Don't even know.
Can you fit through there? Look at that. It is a jungle gym. You made it. Honey, I figured out what the hole is for in the center console. It's for the baby. We can make a little crib down here with blankets and pillows. And we can put the baby there. What do you think?
Yes.
Some of you probably want to know, does the Sienna drive itself?
And here to explain it best is professional minivan driver, car geek, and actor Ingo Rademacher.
Lane tracing assist does a really good job of centering the Sienna in the middle of the lane. And that's one of the problems with some of the older systems is they weren't really strong enough in the electronic steering in order to keep the car in the center of the lane, and they would ping from one side to the other. This one does an incredible job of staying in the center of the lane. It not only does it during highway speeds, but it also does it in stop and go traffic. So if the system can't read the lines, it actually reads the car in front of you and will follow that in stop and go traffic, which is really, really cool. The system really does drive itself. You just have to hold the wheel, put a little bit of pressure on there, but you really don't need to do the steering. It does it for you. So far, the system has proven to be fantastic. Of course, It's not a very smart system in the way it reads between the lines. So if there is an exit ramp coming up, it will tend to pull to the right to want to take you off that, because it wants to center yourself in between those two lanes. So once you know that, you just know to hold the wheel or push cancel and go about your way, or just hold the wheel is fine too, so it doesn't do one of these little swervy things. Once you understand the system, then it really is, it's flawless. Radar cruise control is on, stop and go. It works really smooth. Some systems are a little bit choppy, and this one I have to say is very, very good. This is Red Rock Canyon's one of our favorite places to stop.
If I wanted to play Fortnite, I could just go in my headset, plug it into the back over there. Well, you can't see it, but it's behind like all that stuff, and play it on the TV here.
I guess around the backside, there's the Fossil Falls. I want to go there one of these days, but not today. It looks like the Big Island. It's like a lava all over the place.
Found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up but I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts.
We should do this.
When the sun goes down,
I haven't even seen the movie
and
yet.
The band
That's
won't
right.
play.
We should watch that movie.
No. From Bishop to Mammoth, which is a 2,000 foot climb, and it's only a 2.5 liter four cylinder combined with the hybrid up the hill, 75 mile an hour, which is pretty good and not too noisy. You do hear it rev when you really get on it. It's a combined horsepower torque of about 250. I think the torque might be slightly more, and I promised I would do the MPG numbers on the way to Mammoth. Don't forget, it is a 9,000 foot climb from LA to Mammoth, and we're fully loaded. We've got 100 square foot of hardwood floors in there, all the tools that I need for that. We've got a bunch of honey. That weighs a lot, right?
Yeah.
For Winnie the Pooh right here. We're probably gonna get about 26.5 miles to the gallon, which is nowhere near the 36 promised on the highway. But you have to remember that it's a huge climb up. We've got a bit of headwind as well. And also, just from equivalent vehicles that we've driven up here, like the Honda Pilot, got 17.5 miles to the gallon coming up here. The old Sienna would probably be right around that 17, 18 miles to the gallon mark. One of our other favorite stops in Bishop is Schatz Bakery, where you can get the most amazing fresh bread, local honey, and delicious pastries.
Okay, let's talk about how good this thing is. Pros and the cons. Obviously, I've spent a lot of time in it. This morning, I drove down from Mammoth to go to work. It's a 5-hour drive, got 34.8 miles to the gallon. At about 77 miles an hour, so not bad. Right now, I'm heading back to Mammoth. Peak hour traffic. The system really does drive itself. You just have to hold the wheel, put a little bit of pressure on there, but you really don't need to do the steering. It does it for you. It has quite a strong input of electronic steering. The way you can move the seats around, you can't even get that in a Suburban or an Escalade extended wheelbase. You just cannot. It's only available in a hybrid, which is not my favorite thing. I would love it if they would throw a four-cylinder diesel in this and ditch the hybrid. And maybe we'll have to wait for that. We'll see. I doubt it. Some of the cons, there's a little bit of wind noise and road noise, but they're not deal breakers for me. I like the vehicle enough to put it on the possible purchase list, because the kids love it so much, and because of this autonomous driving feature that it does have with the lane tracing. I haven't been able to test the all-wheel drive system, so I can't really tell you guys how it is in the snow. I'm assuming, because it's all electronic, that it works pretty good. So the hybrid system is a front-wheel drive usually, and if you get the all-wheel drive, you get an electric motor as a rear diff that sends power to each of those wheels back there. Styling-wise, I think it looks great.
I think the XSE is the best looking model in the lineup. It's definitely more sporty and aggressive looking with its 20-inch blacked out wheels.
Interior is really nice. I especially love this whole bridge console that they got going here. There's a ton of storage underneath here. It's wireless phone charging, obviously. Apple CarPlay, I don't even need to mention that. What car doesn't have that nowadays? It feels like you're in a little spaceship in a way. They did a really good job. The screen in the middle right here kind of faces you a little bit, so you have everything at your fingertips. You really don't need to reach for anything. The heated steering wheel, the heated seats, they stay on. So in the morning, if it's cold and you live in a cold climate, you don't have to keep turning them on all the time. They just turn on when the car turns on, which I thought was a really, really great feature.
Get onto I-5 North towards CA-14 North.
Thank you, Siri. I should probably get over at some point. No, it's not a minivan. It is a man van. And especially if you get that aftermarket 3-inch lift kit, I think a lot of dudes are going to be like, yeah, that's my ride right there. Look at all that room. All right, over and out. It could be a man van, especially if you put that 3-inch lift kit on it.
It'll still be a minivan.
Still gonna be a minivan, but it's gonna be a pretty bitchin' minivan.